Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing my recipe for a buffalo chicken pizza. Yes, you heard me right, a buffalo chicken pizza. This pizza is very unique. I sort of came up with it. I know it exists in some restaurants, so I decided to make my own. This recipe was actually requested for a while by a few people, so I'm finally delivering my recipe for a buffalo chicken pizza today. Now, I need you guys to tell me in the comments down below, am I the only one that likes pizza this much? Because it is great. Pizza has to be one of my favorite fast foods out there. So I really hope you guys enjoy my recipe today. Keep on watching to see how I put it together.
All right, guys, the first step before you begin to make your actual pizza is to prepare the pizza dough. Now, I already have a recipe for my favorite pizza dough up on my channel. I will have the recipe linked right up here in the right-hand corner, and I'll have it in the description box down below. You'll want to go ahead and prepare the dough about an hour or two before you want to make your pizzas because you need to allow it to rise. And a little tip, as I said in my pizza dough video, you want to make sure to mix that dough really soft and to knead it very well so you get a beautifully soft and crispy pizza when you're done. Once you've gone ahead and prepared your pizza dough, it's time to prepare the buffalo chicken that'll go on the pizza. I have some chicken breasts here, I have some black pepper, some salt, some mozzarella cheese, some sliced scallions, some buffalo sauce, I have some sliced red onions, a little bit of butter, and a little bit of oil. Now, the cheese, you can use cheese as per your preference. I'm using mozzarella because that's what I like on my pizza, but if you want to switch it up, go ahead and do so. And the chicken is boneless and skinless chicken breasts. So what I'm doing here to start preparing the topping for the pizza is I have my chicken breast and I've sliced it down the middle so this way it can be nice and thin and it'll cook faster. And what I'm doing here is I'm sprinkling it liberally with a little bit of salt and I'm going on with some black pepper. As usual, you want to season as per your taste. And if you want to, you can go sparing with the salt so this way you can taste later and add more if need be. Because remember, you can always add salt, but you can never take it off. So I'm just going to season both sides and then I'm going to show you guys what to do next. Once you finish seasoning both sides of your chicken breasts with some salt and some pepper, you're going to heat up a few teaspoons of oil in the bottom of a skillet. And once it gets hot, you're going to go in with your chicken breast. What you want to do is you want to brown this chicken breast and cook it until it is fully cooked on both sides. After about a minute or two of cooking on one side, you're going to go ahead and flip the chicken and it should be nice and golden brown just like this on this one side. Now I have my heat on a medium-high heat at this point, but depending on your stove and how hot it gets, you're going to want to regulate that heat so the chicken doesn't burn. So I'm going to let it cook for about another minute or two on the next side and then it should be done. Alright guys, so at this point my chicken breasts are done cooking. As you guys can see, both sides are nice and golden brown. You want to have that nice golden brown color as a good indication that the chicken's actually done. Now this chicken cooked for about 5 minutes in total just because it was so thin, but if it's a little thicker, you're going to want to let it cook for a little longer as well. What you want to do is remove the chicken from the pot. You're going to allow it to cool for about 5 minutes and then you're going to chop it up into very small pieces. After you finish chopping it up, what you're going to go ahead and do is in the same pan that you brown the chicken off in, you're going to go ahead and add in your butter, and you're going to allow that butter to melt. Once all of that butter has melted, you're going to go back into the pan with all of your chopped chicken breasts. What you're going to do is you're going to give it a stir and allow these chicken breasts to get nice and coated in that butter. And at this point, we are going to go in with all of our buffalo sauce. And you want to get that buffalo sauce mixed in so this way it coats every piece of the chicken. Now at this point, my pan is on a medium-low heat. The reason being is because I do not want this sauce to evaporate too much. Because remember, you want a nice sauce for your pizza. I just wanted to mention that once you add that buffalo sauce in, you're going to allow this mixture to cook on that medium-low heat for about 4 to 5 minutes, or just until the sauce has a chance to thicken a bit and all of those flavors have a chance to marry. Once that occurs, you're going to go ahead and give it a taste for salt and pepper so it is flavored as per your preference, and then you're going to remove it from the pan and put it in a bowl just to cool down a bit because you do not want to put this hot mixture onto the raw pizza dough. I also wanted to mention that if this mixture gets way too thick and it can't be spread onto the pizza, what you're going to want to do is add in about a tablespoon or two of water just to loosen it up a bit. Once you finish preparing the topping that's going to go on top of your pizza, it's time to put this whole dish together. So as I said before, you're going to want to check out my pizza dough recipe so you can be able to make that pizza dough for your pizza. And based on the recipe that I gave you guys, it will make 2 large pizzas or it will make 3 medium-sized pizzas or many more small-sized pizzas. So I'm going to make about 2 today. So what I'm doing is I split my dough in half and I'm going to roll it out to a 1/2-inch thickness. I like to roll my pizza dough out to about a half inch thickness, maybe a little less than that, because that's my preference. But if you like a really thin crusted pizza, or you like a very thick crusted pizza, then feel free to roll it out as per your desired thickness. So I'm going to continue rolling this out, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to transfer it onto my pizza pan. Once you've transferred your rolled out pizza dough onto your pizza pan, it's time to go on with all of your buffalo chicken topping that you made. Now feel free to put as much or as little of this buffalo chicken topping on as you want. Since I'm making one large pizza, I'm going to go ahead and use all of my filling that I made. Once you've gone ahead and spread your buffalo chicken out as evenly as possible onto the pizza dough, you're going to start sprinkling on your thinly sliced red onions. Now, if you didn't have red onions and you only had regular onions, feel free to use that. And you can also play around with different veggies on top of this pizza. You can even omit the onions if you did not want them. Once you finish sprinkling on all of your red onions or whatever other veggies that you are going to use, it's time to top it with all of your cheese. Now, just like with any type of pizza, some people like a lot of cheese, some people like a little bit of cheese. For me, I like a good balance of the cheese to the topping ratio. So I'm going to go ahead, sprinkle all of my cheese on as evenly as possible so this way it's not clumped around some of the edges. I also wanted to mention that before you start rolling out your pizza dough, you want to have your oven preheated to 400 to 450 degrees. You want the oven pretty hot, so this way the pizza cooks nice and fast and all of the cheese will get browned at the same time. I also wanted to mention that using a non-stick pizza pan works best because this pizza will slide right on and it will slide right off as well. Alright guys, so for me, I popped my pizza into a 425 degree oven for about 15 minutes or just until all of that cheese and the toppings were nice and bubbly on the top. So when I took it out of the oven, I allowed it to cool for just about a minute or two, and as you guys can see, I've just drizzled on a little bit of blue cheese dressing or blue cheese sauce. That's going to give it such a great flavor and complement that buffalo chicken. And I'm going on with some thinly sliced green onions. I promise you guys that these two toppings are really going to make this pizza. Okay guys, that's all I have for you today. I really hope you guys enjoyed this unique and delicious buffalo chicken pizza recipe. I promise you guys are going to want to give it a try because it is so great, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Go ahead and give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you're not subscribed yet. And make sure to keep leaving your comments down below. I'll be sure to see you guys in the next video that I post.